Welcome back. Take a look at this. Our very own Ryan Cannaday competing in this year's Virginia City Camel races. Unfortunately, he didn't win today's race. He did come in second. We're proud of him for that. And he has a closer look at these camels who are born for racing.
It looks a lot like horse racing, but it's much more unpredictable.
He's going!
We're talking about racing camels, where the strategy is to sit back, put your legs straight, and hold on tight, because it's going to be a bumpy ride.
The jockeys get on at the starting gates, and they should be there at the finish line, we hope.
The camels you see here were born to race and have a need for speed, some topping out at more than 20 miles per hour. Each one was raised on a farm in Nickerson, Kansas, but they originally come from a family of wild camels caught in Australia more than 50 years ago.
We've bred for genetics and for good disposition, and not necessarily all race camels, because we give camel rides here too.
These camels stand more than 6 feet high, weigh about half a ton, and can live for about 40 years. This breed is the dromedary, meaning they only have one hump.
If anybody tells you, you know, they say, oh, I got spit on by a camel one time. First thing you ask them, was that a double hump or a single hump, you know? If it's a single hump, they're just making up a story because they do not spit.
But the hump determines a lot more than just whether a camel spits. On the track, it serves as some cushion for the jockey sitting inside the saddle. In the wild, the hump can be used by the camel for survival.
It's filled with muscle and gristle, and they can survive for days and days without feed or water, either one.
And it's not just camels that we're riding here in Virginia City. We've got emus, zebras, and ostriches too. And let me just tell you, each one has its own different characteristics.
If you want to see all the exciting racing for yourself, just head on up to the Virginia City Arena and Fairgrounds this weekend. Covering the story, Ryan Cannaday, Channel 2 News.
It's just so funny.